This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about what happens when we use a zero as the exponent for a number. So in your math class or in your textbook, you've probably been told that raising a number to the zero power is going to make it equal to 1. So 3 to the 0 would equal 1. 27 to the 0 equals 1. 5 to the 0 equals 1. And so on. So let's try to understand why this is the case. We can think of this two different ways. Let's say we have this pattern. I've got the base 2, and I'm going to have 2 to the 4th, and 2 to the 3rd, and 2 squared, and 2 to the 1st. And let's fill in what these numbers equal. Well, 2 to the 1st power is just 2, and 2 squared is twice as much. It equals 4, because we're multiplying by another 2. We had 2, and then we had 2 times 2. When we get to 2 to the 3rd, it's going to be twice as much again. It's going to be 8, because now we're multiplying 2 times 2 times 2. So we're taking the 2 squared, doubling it to make 2 to the 8th. To get to 2 to the 4th, we could multiply 2 to the 8th, I'm sorry, 2 to the 3rd, which equals 8, and that's going to be 2 times 8, and that'll be 16. So working our way up this pattern, from an exponent of 1 to 2 to 3 to 4, we kept doubling the number. We kept multiplying it by the base. If we work our way down the pattern, from 4 to 3 to 2 to 1 as the exponents, we could divide the number in half. 16 divided by 2 is 8. 8 divided by 2 is 4. 4 divided by 2 is 2. And that gets us down to 2 to the 1st. Well, let's continue the pattern. Let's consider 2 to the 0. Well, if we worked our way down the pattern by dividing the previous number, I've got to divide 2 by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. So I end up with 2 to the 0 equals 1. Okay, so this pattern is kind of forcing us into understanding or into seeing that a number raised to the 0 power is going to be 1. Here's another way to think of it. I've got a fraction, 5 to the 4th over 5 to the 4th. Now, if you've learned about dealing with fractions that have exponents, you know that if the bases are the same in the numerator and the denominator, like the 5 that I have here, we take that base, and the power we're going to have is the exponent in the numerator minus the exponent in the denominator. So the exponents in both cases are 4. So I'm going to have 5, and the power is going to be 4 minus 4. Well, 4 minus 4 is 0. So this is 5 to the 0 power. Now remember, I started out with a fraction. The fraction had the same numerator and denominator, 5 to the 4th. When the numerator and the denominator are both the same in a fraction, then the fraction equals 1. So this fraction must equal 1, but it also equals 5 to the 0. So 5 to the 0 would have to equal 1. Okay? So I hope that helps you understand this. Take care. I'll see you next time.